This is JB from Northern Lights over Arkham. This time I will be starting a brand new campaign, and this time I'm playing the Innsmouth Conspiracy campaign, just was released, and the investigator I will be using is Sister Mary. She is the guardian investigator from the Innsmouth Conspiracy expansion, and this will be my first playthrough of the campaign. I will be playing it as the mythos packs and scenarios get released, so there will be some gaps between the plays, and at first I will be playing the first two scenarios, and when we get more scenarios I'll play them then. But let's first look at Sister Mary's deck. So Sister Mary is a guardian with access to level 0 to 5 guardian cards. Also she has access to level 0 to 5 or neutral cards, and also she has the mystic level 0 to 2 access. As you can see, I have used the mystic access quite a lot for Sister Mary. This is to compensate her low intellect, so we have a lot of ways for her to discover clues, either using her high willpower of 4 or using the events that are for clue getting. I've also tried to add a lot of new cards from the Innsmouth Conspiracy cycle, so I opted to take 2 Blessed Blades. This is because Sister Mary adds so many blessed tokens into the bag, so hopefully we can utilize that and get the +1 damage from the Blessed Blade. Also there is 2 copies of Sword Cane, and Sword Cane is a really interesting card because with that I can use Sister Mary's willpower to either fight or evade, so it doubles as a way to evade better. Then there is 1 copy of Rite of Sanctification, because the Chaos Pack will have a lot of blessed tokens hopefully. I'm hoping to get Rite of Sanctification into play and seal up to 5 blessed tokens onto it to reduce the cost of cards by releasing those blessed tokens. As addition to mitigate the encounter deck, we have the Board of Protections, but also the new Board of Radiance cards. So as there are hopefully again a lot of blessed tokens in the bag, I'm hoping when I use the Ward of Radiance to hit at least 1 of those tokens so that we can negate the encounter card, or the treachery card to be more precise. I've also added the Promise of Power because it's I think it may be a strong card, but of course that you have to add a curse token into the bag. It might balance itself out, but again, because we have so many blessed tokens in the bag, it may be that the curse token doesn't play that big of a part, and it commits for 4 wild icons, so it's really versatile. The allies for this deck, I picked David Renfield for a good economy and willpower boost, and also Olive McBride, because I think with the blessed tokens Olive McBride could be really useful, because then you can get those blessed tokens out of the bag and combo this with the blessed blade, for example. Other than that, there are not any new cards from the Innsmouth Conspiracy. I added some of the staple cards like Hallowed Mirror to mitigate damage also, because Sister Mary has only 5 health I added 2 second winds into the deck, so I can heal some damage, hopefully. Sanity is not a problem with Sister Mary, and also her signature asset Guardian Angel is a good health soak, so I'm hoping the health won't be a problem. The random basic weakness was for Sister Mary the Mob Enforcer. We'll see if we have the resources to deal with the Mob Enforcer in this campaign, but that's enough of the deck. Let's see the scenario. So we are playing the Pit of Despair, and because this is the first time I'm playing this scenario or this campaign, I'll read the fluff text. Usually I don't do this to compress the play time of these videos, but because this is the first time possibly somebody's seeing this scenario, and for me to experience the campaign, I like to read the text. So, scenario 1. The Pit of Despair. Your eyes flutter open with the languor of one of who has slept for days on end. Your senses are in no hurry to return. You blink and struggle to see through the inky black surrounding. Every inch of you aches with dull, throbbing pain. Your skin is cold and numb, and your clothes are waterlogged. Your mind swims with half-articulated thoughts and tangled memories. You have no idea where you are or how you got here. You snap to attention, heart racing in your chest. You lie on a jagged stone floor in a shallow pool of dark, ice-cold water. Knowing panic will only make the situation worse, you take a series of deep meditative breaths. You try to remember something, anything, that might allow you to retrace your steps, but your mind is blank. You remember who you are, but nothing whatsoever from the recent past. You steady yourself and examine your surroundings. The chamber appears to be a natural cave formation. Kelp dangles from the ceiling. The stone walls and floors are wet and slimy. A rhythmic drip, drip, drip echoes throughout the otherwise silent cave. This cavern has been underwater, and not too long ago. A result of the tides, perhaps. You swallow your fear like a lump of cold iron. If it's low tide now, a cold shudder ripples up your spine. You examine the ceiling and are surprised to see a slab of metal set into the rough stone overhead. Its polished surface is alien to the rest of the natural cavern. You call out for help, hoping somebody can hear. Your dread deepens at the reply, an awful croaking and gurgling that permeates the tunnels, a sound no human could make. Then let's read the agenda. So, Agenda 1A, Awakening. A salmon lays dead on the ground nearby, its scaly flesh just starting to rot. You can tell from the kelp and the dripping wet walls that this cavern was underwater not too long ago. How much time do you have before high tide? Forced, when your turn begins, if you are at a fully flood location, you struggle for air. When your turn ends, if you did not enter an unflooded or partially flooded location during your turn, take 5 direct damage. And the agenda has a 7 doom threshold. Then let's read Act 1. The Pit. You have awakened in a waterlogged cavern, your mind robbed of its memories, and you are not alone. Whatever else lives in this cavern, it can't possibly be friendly. You have to get out of this place and back to civilization. And we have to get 3 clues per investigator to advance. Also, we start at the unfamiliar chamber. So, Three branching tunnels open before you, each spotted in darkness. A foul odor like that of decaying fish permeates the tunnels. And it's a tree-shroud location with one clue. First, after unfamiliar chamber is revealed, randomly choose one of the set-aside face-down keys and place it on unfamiliar chamber without looking at it. So I have mixed up these keys, so I'll just pick one. And during setup we have the green and the blue key revealed and the rest of the keys that are used in this scenario unrevealed. And we are ready to start. So the setup and intro is done, so let's get started. So I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw our opening hand. So we get the Spectral Razor, Sixth Sense, a Sword Cane, the redraw for the Mob Enforcer, we get the Guardian Angel and Ward of Protection. Okay, so we are definitely keeping the Sixth Sense to help us investigate. I think the Guardian Spirit, well, let's see. When any amount of damage is assigned to Guardian Angel, add that many less tokens to the Chaos Pack, so I think we keep that. Let's just keep the Sword Cane for now. And maybe I'll keep the Spectral Razor. I'll just keep the whole hand, because I think this is a decent starting hand. We have some ways to fight and also good ways to investigate. So I don't feel like I need to try and find something right at the start of the scenario. Okay, and how these keys work is that whenever there are no clues on the location, we can, as a fast triggered ability, take control of the key. Also, if the key is on an enemy, and we defeat that enemy, we take control of each key on that enemy. So if you have played the For the Greater Good scenario, the keys works basically the same as in that scenario. So let's start by playing down the Sixth Sense. It costs 3 resources. Second action. Oh yeah, one important thing. During setup, add 2 Bless tokens to the Chaos Pack, and that we forgot to do. So I add these 2 Bless tokens to the Chaos Pack. And also, free trigger ability. When the round ends, add 1 Bless token to the Chaos Pack. Elder Sign effect, +1 if you succeed, add 1 Bless token to the Chaos Pack. So we'll be hopefully adding quite a lot of Bless tokens into the Chaos Pack during this game. So, second action. I think I'll play the Guardian Spirit down. Just that it's ready. And last action, I'll investigate using the Sixth Sense. And I'm investigating 4 versus 3. So not that high at the moment, but I hope it is enough. So it's a -1, so we succeed and we get this clue. We'll also get this key as a free trigger ability, and it's the purple key. So I'll just place the keys here. And no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw one card, we get David Renfield, and we gain one resource. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. And of course, at the end of the last turn, I forgot to add one Bless token to the Chaos Pack with Sister Mary's ability. So we'll do that now. At the start of the Mythos phase, we'll add one Doom to the agenda. And first encounter card is Macabre Memento. So it's a treachery. Revelation test will power 3. If you reveal a cultist token during this test, you automatically fail. If you fail, take 2 horror. So one thing I forgot to talk about in the start of the game, the Chaos Pack is quite different in this campaign at the start. So there are 2 cultists, 2 tablets, and 2 Elder Thing tokens, and also 2 skulls in the back. So there are 20 tokens total at the start of the campaign. But that's quite a lot more than in the other campaigns, which start usually with maybe 14 or 16 tokens. So we are not in trouble with horror. So I think I'll just save my cards and test this by just testing 4 versus 3. So I get a tablet. So I fail, and if you fail and you control a key, take 1 horror. So we actually end up taking 3 horror. So maybe cancelling would have been a wiser decision. Well, it is what it is, so I'll take the 3 horror. Then we start our investigation phase. First action, I'll take 1 resource. Second action, we'll play David Renfield. I'll add a Doom on David. And I'll exhaust David to generate 1 resource. And last action, let's move. So let's move to... let's move here. So we get Idle Chamber. Actually, yeah, this shouldn't be here. So at the start of the game, we remove Idle Chamber, Altar of Dagon, and Sealed Exit from the Tidal Tunnel deck. So I clearly messed up the setup, so I'll just shuffle and pick one at random. So we hit the Tidal Pool. It's a 3 shroud location with 1 clue. Tidal Pool gets +1 shroud while it is partially flooded and +2 shroud while it's fully flooded. Post after Tidal Pool is revealed, randomly choose one of the set aside face down keys and place it on Tidal Pool without looking at it. So we'll just pick one of these. Add 1 clue here. And that is our turn. So no enemies. We'll go to upkeep. We ready up, draw 1 card, and gain 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We'll add a Doom to the agenda. Encounter card for this turn is... who shuffled this deck? So Macabre Memento. I think I'll try to pass this turn. So... I'll just commit one of the Spectral Razors to the test, or... I am testing with willpower 5 now that I have David in play. So I think 6 versus 3 is good enough. So I'll commit one of the Spectral Razors to the test. It's a 0, so we pass. Oh yeah, and again we forgot to add one less token at the end of our turn. I really need to try and start remembering that. Okay, so that is the Mythos phase. We'll go to the investigation phase. We are investigating 5 versus... before that, I think I'll use Renfield. I'll get one resource. I'll add one Doom, so I'll get 2 resources. We still have plenty of time to get rid of David before the Doom on him becomes troublesome. So let's investigate for our first action. We are investigating 5 versus 3. It's a 0. So we get this clue, and we'll also grab this key, and it's the yellow key. So these keys won't do anything yet, but hopefully soon. Second action, we'll move back to the unfamiliar chamber, and last action, let's go to this side. So it's another tidal pool. So again, there is one randomly just set aside face down key on it. So next turn we'll hopefully get that. No enemies, we go to upkeep. We draw a card, we get the power, promise of power. So this is one of the new cards I wanted to try out. So to play this we have to add one cursed token into the chaos pack. And if we can't, if there are no tokens left, we have to take 2 horror, and it commits for 4, so it's really flexible. And we also now remember to add one token here, so we have 5 blessed tokens in the bag. Hopefully we'll see one of those soon, and we gain one resource. So I think that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 5 of 7 doom. Encounter card for this turn is Young Deep One. So the Young Deep One engages us, and when it engages us, we'll take 1 horror, and I think that is the Mythos phase. So, I think we will just defeat that Young Deep One with the Spectral Razor. So first action. Well, before that, I will add one Doom to the David Renfield and exhaust. So I'll get 3 resources. And then I will investigate. So the Young Deep One makes an attack of opportunity. So Renfield is gone, and we'll take 1 damage, and we'll put it on Guardian Angel. So we add 1 blessed token to the bag. Then we will investigate. So we are investigating 4 versus 3, but I'll commit the promise of power to this test. So we'll add 1 curse token to the back, and we are investigating 8 versus 3. We get a plus 1, so we succeed, and we'll also grab this clue. This key, so we have the red key also. Then second action, I'll use the spectral razor to hit the young deep one. We are hitting 7 versus 3. And it's a elder thing, it's a -3 if you fail, and the amalgam is in the depths, but it your play area engage with you. Yeah, well, the amalgam is not in play, so we still hit. We'll deal 3 damage with the spectral razor, so this young deep one is defeated. And last turn, last action, I think I will move to the unfamiliar chamber. And I think we will advance the act next turn. Okay, so no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw one card, we get the drawn to the flame, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 doom of 7. Encounter card is Memory of Oblivion. Test willpower 4 or intellect 4. If you reveal a Elder Thing token during this test, you automatically fail. For each point you fail by, choose and discard one card from your hand. I think I'm just testing 4 versus 4. Oh yeah, and the end of the last round we'll add another blessed token. So now we have 7 blessed tokens and 1 cursed token in the back. So hopefully we are hitting one of those tokens sometime soon. So the first is a -1. So we fail by 1. And I think I'll just discard the Ward of Protection. And that is that. So, investigation phase. We'll start by spending the clues. So we advance the Act 1. It is the recognition. You find a path that leads deeper into the strange cave system. But before you can follow it to see where it leads, the sound of water sloshing behind you sets your heart racing. When you turn to face the sound, what you see next nearly causes you to faint. It is an enormous hybrid of many faces and shapes, some human, some aquatic, all of them misshapen and revolting. As the thing draws closer, you meet the frozen gaze of one of the faces upon its body, and you realize that you recognize it. Spawn the set aside. The amalgam enemy engaged with the lead investigator. Shuffle each set aside copy of Blind Sense and form from the depths into the encounter deck along with the encounter discard pile. Shuffle each of the set aside tidal tunnel locations together to form the tidal tunnel deck, including the set aside Altar of Dagon, Idol Chamber, and sealed exit locations. Put those locations put locations from the top of the tidal tunnel deck into play below to the left and to the right of each rebel location. Read flashback 1 in the campaign guide. So I'll pause the video, I'll do the setup, and we'll read the flashback 1 after that, so I'll be right back. Okay, so we did the setup. So now we have locations below, left and right to each location that was revealed. So the map will grow depending on when we explore more of this cave or tunnel. So now, first, after a location is revealed, put the locations from the top of the tidal tunnel deck into play below, to the left and to the right of the location, so it keeps on expanding. Then we shuffled the treachery cards into the deck with the discard pile, and we got the amalgam enemy engage with us. So the amalgam is a 3 fight, 3 health and 2 evade monster, abomination deep 1 elite, it's a hunter. Triggered ability, after you successfully evade the amalgam by 2 or more, take control of one key on it. First, after the amalgam engages you, if you control a key, either place one of your keys on it or it attacks you. First, when the amalgam is defeated, place it in the depths. So, I think I'll just place one of my keys on it. We don't want it hitting us. Or actually, we could let it hit us, but I think this is we can evade with the sword cane. So then we read the flashback one. You stand in a small office, examining a worn photograph in a well-polished wooden frame. In the photo, a squad of men in military uniforms pose in front of Bristol F-2 fighter plane. Several of the men wear tan British uniforms, but one sports the olive overcoat and khakis of an American soldier. His sleeves each bear a rectangular patch stripped vertically with the captain's paired silver bars. At the bottom of the photograph, in black ink, cursive handwriting reads British 4th Army outside St. Quentin, 1918. The door to the office opens suddenly, startling you. You put the photograph down and turn to address the man entering. You identify him immediately by his dark brown skin, his strong jaw and his broad shoulders. It is Thomas Dawson, the American from the photograph, though he has aged a bit since his war days, and heavy bags had hang under his eyes. One war ends, a new one begins, he says quietly. Only this enemy is even harder to root out. You ask the man what a war hero is doing in the investigative business, and he chuckles softly in response. War hero? I don't know where you heard that from. I was just doing my duty. You shake your head, but do not argue further. You suspect that the squadron captain Dawson rescued would disagree as well. In any event, I suppose you're wondering why I summoned you here in Boston, he says, gesturing for you to take a seat in front of his desk. You sit and respond to his remark with affirmation, wondering aloud why a telephone call would not have sufficed. This is a sensitive matter, he replies. A few days ago, I lost contact with one of my agents, a Miss Elena Harper. I had her investigating several strange reports I've received in the past few months, all concerning a town called Innsmouth. Do you know the place? It's along the coast to the north of your town of Arkham, just by Ipswich. You know the place, though most have never heard of the shadowed, decrypt seaport. Those who do hear only ill rumors. From what you understand, the town used to be a lively port before the War of 1812, but it has since become dingy and run down. The only railway lines that runs through Innsmouth is abandoned, and there are no references to the town on any maps or in any guidebooks you have ever seen. Perhaps she's found something curious or has gone into hiding, but I suspect foul play. It could be mob work, but I doubt it. I'm not sending any more agents until I know for sure. However, I have some room in our discretionary budget to hire a third party, such as yourself. You assume Agent Dawson is dancing around the truth, which is that you are expendable. I know it isn't much to go on, but I need to know the status of Agent Harper. Even bad news would be better than no news at this point. If you do me this favor, our agency will be in your debt. You ask which agency Dawson is referring to, a smirk tugs at his lip. When you snap back to the present, you still gaze at Agent Dawson's face, Only now his smirk is twisted in a haunting visage of agony. It is just one of the many faces that writhe in torment throughout this repulsive creature's scaly pulsating flesh. In your campaign log, under Memories Recovered, record a meeting with Thomas Dawson. Now we continue our investigation phase, so... let's see the act again. So we have the objective. There must be a way out of here somewhere. If each surviving investigator has resigned, advance. So this is the last act, so we need to find a way to resign. But first we need to deal with this amalgam. First action, I will play the sword game. So playing sword game doesn't provoke attacks of opportunity. After sword game enters play, immediately trigger its action ability without paying its cost. So exhaust sword game, fight or evade. You may use your willpower instead of fight or agility for this attack or evasion attempt. So we'll play down the sword game and we will evade. I'm evading 4 versus 2. Okay, so we finally hit one less token, so that's a +2, but we draw another token. And we get a tablet, so it's a -2, so we succeed by 2. This gets removed from the bag, and we get this key back, and this amalgam is evaded. Okay, so second action, let's move over here. And we find the underwater cavern. So it's a two-shroud location with one clue. Action move. Move from underwater cavern to any flooded cave location. First, after underwater cavern is revealed, it becomes fully flooded. And we have to add one location here. And we put a fully flooded token on it. So if we end our turn here, we'll take 5 direct damage, so we can't stay here and investigate, but we also don't need the clues right at the moment, so I think we'll just move again, and we'll move here, and we find the underground river. It's four-shroud location with two clues. Underground river cannot be fully flooded. And it forced after underground river is revealed, increase its flood level, so it becomes partially flooded. So we'll add one token there. And that is our turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, be ready. Cars, yeah, the sword can should have been exhausted too when we used it, so it readies also. And we'll draw a card, we get another sixth sense, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Oh yeah, before we end, we'll add another bless token into the bag. Also, because we revealed another location, we'll add a couple of new locations into the play area. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add the fifth doom, and counter card for this turn is Memory of Oblivion. I'm just testing it 4 versus 4 willpower. We get a -2, so we fail by 2, so we have to discard both of our cards, unfortunately. I would have liked to play the drawn to the flame here, but it is what it is. First action. I think I won't stay here and investigate, so I'll keep on looking for the way out. So first action will move. I'll move down here. It's another underground river. It becomes partially flooded. And we'll add another token. Location, I mean. This is the last card, so I think I'll add it here. And second action, we'll just move there. So we find the fish graveyard. Fish graveyard is a 2-shroud location with 1 clue. Forced after you end your turn in fish graveyard. If you do not control a key, take 1 horror. Fast trigger ability. If there are no clues on fish graveyard and you control the red key inside that, we can read flashback 3. So inside a pile of half-rotten fish guts, you find a strange figure. The red key fits into it perfectly. Read flashback 3 in the campaign guide. So I think I'll try to investigate for our last action. I'm investigating 4 versus 2. And it's a bless token, so I'm at 6 versus 2. And it's a minus 3, so I succeed and I don't fail. So we remove the bless token and we get the clue. Also, we now can read flashback number 3. So flashback number 3 reads, "Hey, take a look at this. Your employer shoves a strange figurine into your hands. It is hewn of emerald stone and looks vaguely aquatic, with 2 unblinking eyes and a row of sharp teeth. A piece of heart-shaped amber is embedded in its center. What do you make of it? Do you reply that you have seen nothing quite like it before, but it does happen to match the description you have heard of the devils that skulk about the reefs at a couple of miles beyond the harbor. Something fishy is going on here. If you'll pardon my saying," the man mutters, folding his arms across his chest, "I'm glad I roped you in on this case. It's looking less and less like mob work with each passing hour." You nod in agreement and hand the strange figurine back to the agent. "Everything about this town feels foul to you. Let's stick together from here on out," our companion says with voice darkening. "In your campaign log under Memories Discovered, record a decision to stick together. Remove 1 tablet token from the chaos pack for the remainder of the campaign." Okay, so it seems that these flashbacks are a way to get some of these bad tokens out of the bag. So we remove 1 of the tablet tokens from the bag. That is our turn. We go to enemy phase. So the amalgam hunts here. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get the promise of power. And we gain 1 resource. And we also add 1 bless token to the bag. Okay. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 6, Doom of 7. Encounter card is... it's a lurking deep one. So, it's a 2 fight, 2 health and 4 evade humanoid monster deep one. Prey lowest agility. Forced after lurking deep one engages you, take 1 damage. So we'll take 1 damage. I'll take it on Guardian Angel. So we add 1 less token to the bag. And it is not a hunter, so I think we could try to evade it with the sword cane. And just leave it here. Ok, Okay, so first action, I use the sword cane. I'll commit promise of power to the test, so we'll add one curse token to the bag. This is quite heavy to shuffle this many tokens, so let's see. I'm testing 8 versus 4. We get a bless token, so 10 versus 4. And it's an auto fail. Okay, so we remove the bless token, we fail. That is unfortunate. Well, second action, we'll try to evade again. We just evade with our agility of 3. So 3 versus 4. It's another blessed token. So we are 5 versus 4. And it's a 0. So we remove that and we evade. And last action. Let's move here. Oh dear. We hit the underwater cavern. So this is not a good place to end our turn. So it's a two-shroud location. Forced after underwater cavern is revealed, it becomes fully flooded. And when your turn begins, if you're in a fully flooded location, you struggle with air. When your turn ends, if you did not enter an unflooded or partial... Yeah, so... Okay, well, if we move out of here, then we won't take that. That is my understanding, because the forced effect doesn't trigger because we didn't start our turn. So now we have to next turn move out of here, so we don't take the 5 damage. Okay, so enemy phase, this hunts here. And this ready is in the upkeep. This ready is... We draw a card, we get the Ward of Radiance. And we gain one resource. Okay, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 7 Doom. So we advance the agenda. So, the flood begins. Your worst fears are coming true. Puddles of water that had barely reached your ankles are rising and joining one another. You scramble to find higher ground, but your efforts are for naught. In a matter of minutes, the water level has risen to your knees and shows no sign of slowing. Increase the flood level of each revealed location. Until the end of the game, each time a location is revealed, increase its flood level. Keep this card next to the act deck as a reminder and advance to agenda 2A. Okay, so this can't be fully flooded, so this fish graveyard becomes partially flooded. So does these tidal pools and this unfamiliar chamber, and these are already fully flooded. Okay, and the other locations are not revealed yet. Let's read the water rises. So your every movement is coupled with a loud splashing of rippling water all around you. If the tide continues to rise, the cavern will be completely submerged in a matter of hours. Forced, when your turn begins, if you are at a fully flooded location, you struggle for air. When your turn ends, if you did not enter an unflooded or partially flooded location during your turn, take 5 direct damage. Okay. So, investigation phase. Yeah, this guy should be here. So, oh yeah, we still need to take the encounter card. So it's Riptide. Revelation. If your location is unflooded, Riptide can search. Otherwise, test Agility 3. 4 instead if your location is fully flooded. If you fail, choose and discard one asset you control. If you cannot, lose one resource for each point you fail by instead. So I think I'm well, I can lose the Guardian Angel. That's not that big of a deal. So we'll just test the agility 4 versus 3. Because we are in a fully flooded location. And it's a tablet. If you fail and you control a key, take one horror. Okay, so we'll take one horror. We'll also lose the Guardian Angel. Oh yeah, and we forgot to add one bless token back at the end of the last round. So, yeah. But I'm still not redrawing. And I didn't want to use Ward of Radiance to that test. But yeah, we lost the Guardian Angel. That sucks, but let's continue. So, first action, we'll move to the Tidal Tunnel. And it's the sealed exit. So, it's a 5 shroud location. If an investigator at sealed exit controls the green key, resign. You unlock the gate and swim through the tunnel to freedom. Return all of your clues to the location pool and place all of your keys on this location when you resign. First, after sealed exit is revealed, it becomes fully flooded. Okay. So, we can't stay here. We don't have the green key, so we'll just move here. And we'll move here. So we don't end our turn in a fully flooded location. Enemy phase, this guy hunts here. That guy isn't the hunter. We go to upkeep, we draw a card. We get the blessed blade. We gain one resource and we add one blessed token to the bag. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. And counter card for this turn is Undertow. Revelation. If your location is unflooded, Undertow gains search. Otherwise, put Undertow in play in threat area. Forced after you move, take 2 damage and 2 horror, discard Undertow. Fast triggered ability. Discard one card from your hand. Test strength 3 or agility 3 to fight the pull of the tides if you succeed. Discard Undertow. So I think I'll use the Ward of Radiance to this test. And we reveal 5 random tokens. So we are only looking for blessed tokens or the Elder Sign. So if one of these is Bless or Elder Sign, we succeed. Nothing else matters. So we find the Bless token and an Elder Sign token, but we don't remove anything. We just put them back because this wasn't a skill test. So we cancel that treachery. And that is that. We go to the investigation phase, we'll move to tidal pool, then we'll move to this tidal tunnel. We find the idol chamber. First, after idol chambers is revealed, place the set aside blue key on it. Fast trigger ability, if there are no clues on idol chamber and you control the purple key. The purple key opens the stone door at the far end of the chamber, revealing a shrine with 2 familiar statues. One of white marble, the other of onyx. Read flashback number 4 in the campaign guide. So we try to investigate this location for our last action. Get the clue. We are investigating 4 verses. So So Amalgam is not in the death, so it doesn't matter, but we still fail because it's a minus 3. But nothing else happens, so that is our turn. Enemy phase, the Amalgam hunts here, upkeep. Oh yeah. Yes, and this location is partially flooded. Okay, so that is, we get a card. Well, we get Olive McBride. That is actually really good. And gain one resource. I'll just compress some of these resources. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom. Oh yeah, and the Doom threshold is 8. So the encounter card for this turn is Rising Tide. Increase the flood level of the nearest location that can have its flood level increased. If no location's flood level is increased by this effect, Rising Tide gets surge. So this is the closest we can increase. So my turn begins, so this fourth action triggers, so we need to get out of here this turn. First action, I will play Colin McBride. Then I will investigate. I'll use Olive. Oh yeah, and at the end of the last round, we forgot to add one blessed token again into the bag. Okay, so I'm revealing 3 tokens and canceling 1. So, well, let's see. We are cancelling this because we would take damage, so we fail the investigation. Well, that didn't help at all. So last action, we'll have to move here because we would take the 5 direct damage and die from that, so we can't stay there. Okay, so enemy phase, the Amalgam moves here, engages us, we lose one of our keys, I'll lose the yellow key. And yeah, it attacks us for 1 damage and 1 horror. Oh yeah, I've had these in the wrong spots. Okay, upkeep, we draw a card, and we gain 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom, and counter card is Swarm of Rats. So we need to somehow deal with those rats also. So first action, I will use the actually first action, I'll just punch the rats. So I'm hitting 3 versus 1. Oh yeah, Olive isn't exhausted anymore. We get a bless. Oh yeah, and we actually added another bless token to the back at the end of the last round. And it's a cultist, so we hit. We don't fail. And the rats are dead. Second action, I'll use Olive. We'll use the sword cane to evade. I'm evading 4 versus 2. We get plus a 0 and auto fail, so I'll cancel the auto fail. We draw another token for the plus. it's another bless, which we didn't want to see. It's another bless. Oh no, now we're emptying the bag. And it's a cultist, so we succeed, but we lose 3 bless tokens. And we get this key back. And the amalgam is faded. Last action will move here. And that is our turn. So, enemy phase, nothing happens. We add 1 bless token, so we don't forget. And we ready up. We draw a card, we get the shriveling, and we gain 1 resource. So, yeah, and this readies. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom here, encounter card is a young deep one. Well, that sucks. So, I think our first action is to evade this deep one. I will use Olive. I will use the sword cane. So we are drawing 3 tokens. And so this one, so we evade 4 against 3 and we get -3/4, so we fail. Oh yeah, and this guy engages us, we take 1 horror. What about that? Well, that sucks. Oh yeah, this is not really good. I think we'll have to take... Yeah, we'll just have to bait again. Don't have anything to commit to the test, so... We are evading 3 versus 3. It's a Elder sign, so... +1, we succeed. We add 1 bless token to the bag. This is evaded, but we have to move out of here so we don't die. And this guy gauges us, steals 1 of our keys. I think that is a lost cause. We just can't deal with these enemies and get that. And that guy hits us in the enemy phase, so we'll take 1 damage and 1 horror. And that is that, so enemy phase, yeah, that guy hits us. And upkeep, this guy ready is, he's ready. We'll add 1 less token to the back. Draw 1 card, another sword cane, and gain 1 resource. Okay, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. Counter card is from the depths. If the amalgam is in the depths, put it into play, engage with you. Otherwise, place the amalgam in the depths and the form the depths gains search. So this amalgam goes away. I'll just every token and stuff remains on amalgam, so the key is gone with him. So I'll just place it over here. It's in the depth, so it's not in play, but we can't affect it. That helps us a bit. And it can search, so... Macabre Memento. We really can't commit anything to this test, so I think... just have to take it in the face. So 4 versus 3. It's a -1, so we succeed and don't take any horror from that. Okay. I think we'll just have to leave that location and forget about the blue key. We need the green key to get out, so it's not the end of the world. So first action, we'll move to the tidal tunnel. So it's the Altar of Dagon. 3-shroud location with 0 clues. Action, if investigators at Altar of Dagon control the blue key or 3 or more other keys, they may spend 2 clues at per investigator as group. They control the set aside green key. Well, now it really sucks that the amalgam stole our key. So this location gets partially flooded. I think we'll go check out this last location. Oh, no. I think I'll play the shriveling. So that we have a way to fight. And could actually play the other sword game, so we have a let's not do that yet. Let's draw one card. Okay, so we get second wind, which will at least help us heal a bit. So this guy hunts here. And that is the enemy phase. We go to upkeep, we draw clairvoyance, and we gain one source. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. Encounter card is fractured consciousness. Test intellect tree. If you reveal a tablet token during this test, you automatically fail. If you fail, take 2 damage. Okay. I'll commit the clairvoyance to the test. Just fail it, and I'll use the second wind, maybe. So I'm testing. Let's put it at 0. So I'll use the clairvoyance. So 0 versus. At the end of the last round, we added one less token to the back. Always forgetting about that one. Testing 3 versus 3. And it's a -2, we pull another token. It's a +1, so we still fail, but we got rid of the curse token. We'll take 2 damage. Okay. I think I'll have to play the second wind. So I heal 1 damage 2 instead if you drew a treachery in this round, so I did. So I heal 2 damage. Second action, we'll move here. And this guy engages us, so we take 1 horror. And actually let's not do that. So I'll move over here, so we'll circle around to get past that guy next turn. Okay, I think, so that was the second action. action. I think I'll draw a card. We get David Renfield. Well, not that helpful. But that is our turn. Enemy phase. This guy hunts. I'll hunt here. We go to upkeep, we draw one card, we get the Hallow of Mirror, gain one resource. So that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We add another Doom, counter card is. From the depths, if the Amalgam is in the depths, put it into play, engage with you, otherwise place the Amalgam in the depths and from the depths gain search. So the Amalgam comes into play, it engages us. Well, this actually might help us. So after the Amalgam engages you, if you control a key, either place one of your keys on it or it attacks you. So I think I'll let it attack me so I can evade it and get that key. So it hits us for one damage and one horror. But we don't lose another key. And that is the Mythos phase. We'll go to the enemy phase, the investigation phase actually. So I'll use the Sword Cane and Olive. Oh yeah, and so Olive to evade with the Sword Cane. Okay, we'll cancel this autofail, so we get a minus one total. We are succeeding, but not by two. And we get the plus two, so now we are succeeding by three. And we get the Elder Sign, so we succeed by 4. We remove these two, but we add one to the back. Add these to the back, and we grab this key. Evade here. Second action, we can move here. And last action, we have three keys, so we can get the green key, which we need to resign with. And enemy phase, this guy hunts here. And nothing else, we go to upkeep. We draw a card, we get the Ward of Radiance, we add one Blessed Token to the back, so we have 10 Blessed Tokens in the back. And we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, so I just noticed that we don't have the two clues per investigator to get this key. So instead, let's say I drew a card last turn. So yeah, for each blessed token in the chaos bag, you must either replace it with a cursed token or take one horror. Okay. this is gonna get rough from now on. So Okay, this is maybe one of the annoying things with these tokens. If you have to remove all the tokens, add some of the tokens or something like that to the back, it takes a bit of time. So we have 10 less tokens, so I can take a couple of horror, but I don't see any point in that, so I'll just remove everything. Actually, there, I would have drawn that card last turn, so I would have added one here, so I only add 9, only, but there are only 9 curse tokens here, so we have all the curse tokens in the back. And yeah, and I don't have the key to resign, so that sucks. So instead, let's see this turn. So we are at the middle space. We advance. Okay, so high tide. You panic as the water level continues to rise within the cavern. Before long, you are swimming instead of walking the flooded cavern floor. Many of the tunnels are fully submerged. If you don't get out of here quickly, there will be nowhere safe to catch your breath. Each revealed location becomes fully flooded. Until the end of the game, each time a location is revealed, it becomes fully flooded. Okay. So these can't be fully flooded. That still applies. So those are the only safe locations for me to catch my breath, but enemies are blocking the way. So I think this will be the end of the game. We still get an encounter card, and it is Fracture Consciousness. So we might just die here. I can try to cancel that. So we pull 5 tokens, and we are looking for a Bless token or Elder Sign. So luckily we got the Elder Sign. Actually I pulled 1 token too many, so I have to redo this. Unfortunately. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So no luck. Canceling that. Then we'll do the test. I'll commit Renfield to the test. Testing 3003. I'll just use Olive, because if we fail, Olive will die. I'll cancel this one. So we just fail, we'll take 2 damage, so we'll take 1 damage here, and Olive is dead. Then we go to investigation phase. I really don't see any way out of this situation, because we can't get to a location which isn't fully flooded. We can get here by moving through those 2 enemies. That doesn't help us. So the only thing I think I can do is to get this and read the flashback, so maybe that at least helps us in the long run. So first 2 actions I'll move here, last action we'll investigate, and I'll use the read the signs to investigate. I'm investigating 6 versus 4. And this event isn't guaranteed, so... Well, at least we got the minus 1, so we grab this clue. And we can grab this key. And... Let's see. So we can read flashback number 4. So, flashback number 4. You stand before a terrible onyx statue in a dark, dingy basement. It smells of stale, dank air and rotting fish. The statue depicts a creature that is a hybrid of both fish and human, covered in hideous misshapen scales. Grotesque gills and fins blend with tortured human features. Its large, round eyes glare at you. In the distance, you hear the faint chanting of some kind of ceremony. Ihaltel. The voices cry. Just as you begin to make out the strange syllables, a splash behind you catches your attention. You duck behind the onyx statue and wait patiently as several figures approach where you stood just moments before. You hold your breath, the gentle sloshing of their steps as they wade through the water passes and fades into the distance. You allow a brief sigh of relief, but begin to follow close behind. In your campaign log under Memories Recovered, record an encounter with a secret cult. Remove one Elder Thin token from the Chaos Bag for the remainder of the campaign. So, at least if we survive, we get rid of one of the Elder tokens. Let's see. So we remove one of these. And we end our turn. We take 5 direct damage, so just take 2-3 counters. So we are defeated by damage, so we take 1 physical trauma. And if no resolution was reached because each investigator was defeated, you sputter and cough up an entire lungful of dirty water and sand. Cold, dark seawater laps at your skin as you spit the last of the bitter salt taste back into the rolling tide. A pair of warm hands shoves you onto your back and pulls you up into a sitting position. Thank goodness you're alive, someone says. Even though the strained voice you can hear, a rhythmic Indian accent, and the unwavering confidence of a trained profession. As your eyes adjust, they take in a sky of dark crimson, the full moon hanging just below the blackened sun. We have no time to spare. Come on, get up. You wipe stinging salt water from your eyes, your strength returning slowly. Your savior is a woman with long raven black hair. Her tattered trench coat has seen better days, and bruises splash across her dirt-covered skin. You seem confused. Who are you looking at me? Why are you looking at me like that? The stranger asks. Each investigator earns experience equal to the victory X value of each card in the victory display, and it's 0. Record the experience under unspent experience in your campaign log, but do not spend any of it yet. You will be instructed to spend it in this, to spend this experience at the later time. Proceed to interlude 1, puzzle pieces. So, interlude 1, puzzle pieces. You have no idea who this woman is or how she knows you, yet she seems comfortable and familiar with you. You strain your memory trying to think of how you might have met, but it's no use. You're certain she is a complete stranger. Having awoken in a cold, wet prison with no memories, you aren't feeling very sociable. You fear and distrust must show because the woman backs off and narrows her eyes. What is it? What's wrong? You respond by asking the woman if you know her. You truly don't remember. Well, that's going to complicate things. What do you recall? Do you remember anything? You relate to the woman the flashes of recollection that you experienced earlier. Check the memories recorded section of the campaign log. Read each of the following sections below that apply to your situation, then proceed to the following text. If a meet with Thomas Dawson is listed under memories recovered, you put two and two together and ask if the woman is Miss Harper. Ah, so you do remember me, she asks with a playful smirk, but you shake your head in response and explain that you only remember being hired by a man called Thomas Dawson to find her. But that was, you have forgotten a lot, haven't you? Speaking of Dawson, where is he? Did you see him down there? Your thoughts turn to the twisted, mangled face that triggered your flashback. Agent Harper's expression turns dour as she watches you, your eyes. I see. I wish he hadn't come to this forsaken town. Those brutes are going to pay for this. You ask who she thinks is responsible for Dawson's death, and she raises her eyebrows in response. Right, you don't remember. As far as I know, the last time anybody saw either of you was just before you visited the Esoteric Order of Dagon. Draw your own conclusions. Conspiracy deepens. Each investigator records one additional experience under unspent experience. If a decision to stick together is listed under memories recovered. So, you and Dawson were looking for me together then? Interesting. She considers this for a moment. I guess even the extraordinary Captain Dawson can be rattled from time to time. It's somewhat gratifying to know he cared that much about finding me. Still, her gaze wanders towards the horizon. All right, Dawson. I'll make sure you didn't die in vain. I'll burn this whole town to the ground if I have to. The conspiracy deepens. Each investigator records one additional experience under unspent experience. If an encounter with the secret cult is listed under memories discovered, you describe your memory from inside some kind of cult headquarters. Sounds like that must have taken place inside the Esoteric Order of Dagon building on the north side of town, Agent Harper reasons. That organization is vile. I just know it. I have no evidence to bring back, though, and it sounds like you've forgotten everything you learned. She nurses under her breath. The conspiracy deepens. Each investigator records one additional experience under unspent experience. You point to the strange crimson horizon behind Agent Harper and note aloud the alignment of the sun and the moon. That began just after you and Agent Dawson entered the Order's headquarters, she explains. That was almost 3 days ago. I have no idea what it means, but I can't imagine if it is anything good. All of Innsmouth's been locked tight lately. Not a soul inside. You're lucky I figured out where to look for you. Your mind reels. The last thing you remember before waking up in that dank pit was enjoying a pleasant late summer eve in Arkham. Now you're in another town altogether, and your memory is filled with gaping holes. You wonder aloud what the date is there, and Agent Harper replies, it's the 24th of September. I don't know when exactly you arrived in Innsmouth, or how much of your memory is missing. Isn't there anything else you remember, anything at all? The water sloshes against your feet as you struggle to remember. In minutes, the tide has risen several inches, and there's no sign of it slowing down. You fix your gaze on the woman who stands before you. Her weary eyes, her disheveled clothes, their red marks on her wrists, and something triggers in your recollection. Wake up, we're almost there. The memory lurks at the precipice of your consciousness, threatening to draw you into the darkness. Hey, wake up, I said. You clutch your forehead as searing pain pounces through your skull. Wake up, damn it. Darkness pulls at the edges of your vision. More memories come floating back. Proceed to scenario 2, the vanishing of Elena Harper. Okay, so that was the bit of Dispair with Sister Mary. In the end, we got 3 experience and 1 mental trauma. So next time I will do some upgrades to the deck and then we'll play the second scenario. But until that, thanks for watching and until next time.